Once upon a time, a bamboo was thrown in the fire and it exploded in a big bang. That is how firecrackers were discovered. Have you seen this one? I'm sure you have, and a lot of us use this during Diwali. This one is called a ground spinner and is generally used by a lot of children who want to see firecrackers on the ground. There are two versions of this, if you're aware. The one is a smaller version, which is called a jumping jack. And there's another one which blooms like a flower. It releases sparks in all the directions the moment it starts spinning. And hence it is called a blooming flower. The name of these firecrackers, ground spinners, itself suggests what they mean. They spin on the ground in different directions and emit different colors of sparks. While jumping jacks may move around aimlessly in different directions and may not be an incredible sight to watch, blooming flowers are the ones that stay in our eyes and in our hearts for a long time, because when you look at it from a distance, it looks like there's a flower that is blooming and coming close to you. In this way, in today's video, we are going to learn a lot more about firecrackers, the different types of firecrackers that we use in almost every Diwali and almost every other festival. Although this time I know that a lot of us haven't burst firecrackers for the good, but we definitely know and see them in the sky a lot of times. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, then please do, because I put a lot of videos every alternate day or in every 2 or 3 days on this channel, and you will have a lot to learn from this channel. Also, don't forget to hit the bell icon so that every time a new video comes out, you will be notified about it. Do share this video with your family and friends if you found it useful. Let's get going. The next one is the one that we've all used as children and has been specifically designed for children. Because children cannot use the firecrackers that are bigger and are scared, and hence these are created specially for them. These are called sparklers. Sparklers are the ones that children can hold right in their hand at a distance, of course, so that they do not get hurt with the sparks that fall. When we've used these sparklers as children, we have tried to create a lot of designs and patterns in the air while using these sparklers. They are the ones that emit golden sparks or golden lights and are generally safe to use as long as you handle them well. There are two varieties of sparklers that are available too. The ones that are made up of metal and the other ones that are made up of paper. Now, if you want your kid to be really safe and not burn his or her fingers, then you can use the paper ones, which are called morning glories. The metal ones are of course more expensive and may not be safe because your child may burn the hand until the spark goes off. Now let's look at this one. This one is a firecracker that's very common. And the moment someone says firecrackers, in most of our eyes, this is the one that appears. This one is multicolored and blasts in the sky at a particular height. The moment it is launched, it doesn't really leave any trail behind or a tail behind, but directly goes at a certain height and explodes. And it explodes into multicolored display of sparks that we all love to watch. It just creates a gorgeous display in the sky. I'm sure you've seen all of these during this Diwali as well. And this one is called a peony. So peony is the one that's a common firework that we all see in the night sky during festivities. The next one is this. This one has been named after a famous flower. Do you know the name of this flower? If you do, you can pause this video and let me know in the comments below. This one is called a chrysanthemum and has been named after the flower called chrysanthemum. This one is like a peony. It goes right in the sky at a particular height and then explodes into beautiful colors. Although, unlike peony, it leaves behind a small faded trail. And hence, if you look at this firecracker from a distance, you would see that there's a white trail that is left behind, and then there's this firecracker that bursts in the shape of chrysanthemum, and hence the entire sight, the entire visual display looks like a flower in the sky. This one is also a gorgeous sight to see on festivities. The next one is the one that I recently saw in my area, and that is generally smaller than the chrysanthemum or the peony, but it is again a wonderful sight to watch. It looks like a fish that is going up and again blasting into smaller fishes, and hence it is called a flying fish. The reason it is called a flying fish is because the way you see smaller fishes in the water going around quickly and then disappearing, in the same way, this firecracker starts with the small fish-like movements, goes up in the sky and then bursts into smaller fishes. So you see a lot of them at a high frequency coming one after the other and then bursting into the smaller ones. And hence it is also called a beehive. The next one is this. And this one also has been derived from a tree and has been named after it. This firecracker leaves behind longer trails that we can see in the night sky, and hence the name willow. The last one that we're going to look at in part 1 of the type of firecracker series is this one. This one is called a smoke bomb. The reason being, they emit a lot of smoke. Now there are a lot of varieties that are available in smoke bombs. Some of them emit smoke just for a few seconds, and hence they are cheaper. The expensive versions of it can emit smoke for a longer time. If you've seen pre-wedding shoot videos or photographs, you will see that a lot of couples these days use such smoke bombs in their photographs. So smoke bombs are not designed to explode, they just emit smoke. Guys, if you've liked this video, do hit the like button and share this video with your family and friends if you found it helpful. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon.